So tell me some of the things you're after, Reza. What are you looking for?
Well, for one thing is to give more attention to the health as opposed to to day-to-day activity of run around of the work environments and get back to paying some attention to the health, especially at this age, to kickstart a new phase before getting really old, and a habit of a healthy lifestyle, from eating habit to exercise to daily activity. So get back to hopefully 20 pound less, maybe, to get into an ideal BMI that I want to be. And
okay, you're actually in good shape, if I may show. You're actually, you've got a really good physique. Oh, we all can use a little tuning up, probably.
Exactly, that's
right.
That's what I'm looking for.
And it only takes 20 pounds to drop into your ideal health for a lot of people. Prevent diabetes, high blood pressure, cholesterol, and osteoarthritis, knee replacement.
And the list goes on and on, I understand.
All the stuff that costs you a fortune
later
can be prevented now. And it's actually very rare to get someone this young with that much foresight. Because usually I see people 60, 70, 80, and by then they're, running on fumes, so to speak. This is actually really good that you're doing it this
age. Thank you.
So tell me about, when was the best shape of your life? How old were you? What were you doing?
Best shape of my life was, I would say, between 1995 and 1998, when I ate on a regular schedule, healthy habit, and exercise 2 hours a day, 6 days a week at the gym.
Two hours a day, 6 days a week.
Yes, and that was a regular regimen, 7 to 9 a.m. every morning, except Sunday. So that was when I was in the best shape of my life. I was around 142 pounds and around 17% body fat.
Okay.
So
17, and you were what weight?
142.
I'm gonna come over here and get a little bit different angle.
Yes.
So that's really good. The problem with that is your body can't sustain that kind of workout.
Correct.
So I call it charging your metabolic credit card at that age, which now at our age you have to pay it back with interest.
Correct.
So those kind of aggressive, like the P90X, et cetera, work great in the short term, but eventually the weight comes rebounding with a vengeance because you've overtaxed your adrenal glands and now it's much easier to gain weight.
Yes.
So we want to find something moderate, sustainable, that you can continue to lean down the rest of your life. Get lean, stay lean, and not gain it back. Not yo-yo. And that's very difficult. It's very rare to see anyone do that. I think one of the keys is finding exercise that's good. For you, do you like to walk?
Yes.
I might recommend you start walking about an hour a day.
Okay.
On your non-weightlifting days.
Okay.
And then you want to lift weights about 2 to 3 times per week.
Okay.
No more than that.
Two.
No more 6-7 days a week.
Correct. Yes.
Give your body some time to recover from its fatigue. And we're talking about low volume weightlifting workouts, like 30 to 45 minutes max, with a lot of rest in there.
Okay.
And I can send you a sample workout regimen if that's something to get you started. How about diet? What diet has worked best for you in the past?
Well, I have these days, just in the past 3 months, reduced on red meat and moved toward a little more poultry and fish, and but still I'm on rice and bread and some of the high carb diet, and I would say moderate to high carb diet for a long time, which is a habit that I have to cut down.
Okay.
I feel that way.
So essentially on the Persian diet.
Exactly.
Lots of rice.
Lots of rice.
Kebab.
And lots of, yeah, that's right. So
okay.
So that has been a consistent diet, I would say, in the past 10 years.
There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, that's possible to do it with a strictly Persian diet. It's quite advanced though. I mean, you have to really dial in your macros, you have to really time your eating rhythms. So it's kind of a postgraduate, postdoctoral type. I think we should do something kind of a little easier to get rolling with immediately that has a fast learning curve. So I might recommend something like a modified slow carb diet, and I can send you this diet as well. So slow carb, essentially you want to reduce the breads, the rice, the cereals, the chips, but eat them at certain times. For example, right after finishing a weightlifting session, the gloves are off. You can have your carbs right then. So it's gonna go into the muscle, right? Within 30 to 60 minutes.
Okay.
And then have a cheat day once a week where essentially you eat as many donuts, cheesecake, Twinkies, Pop-Tarts that you want, Captain Crunch cereal. That gives you a good insulin spike once a week, because on every diet you've ever been on, for most of us, after 6 weeks, we tend to plateau, or 2 months. And then it starts to come right back, right? It's because we don't get a good cheat day. You gotta have the cheat day where you get the carbs in.
That's a true story for me too.
Has that happened to you?
Yes. So maintaining for a few months in a good diet, and then gradually, you know, going back, and then, you know, going high loads on the carb that was missed. So body tells you that eat more. And also impacting the eating at the wrong time,
right,
as well.
Okay, so let's look at putting the rice and the breads at certain key times after workouts and on Saturdays, if that's your cheat day. And then as you get more experienced, as you get leaner, then your body can handle more carbs every day, because your insulin resistance will go way down. You'll get new muscle that's not been damaged by years of carbs. Your insulin receptors will be made new, undamaged. You can handle the carbs better. In fact, at that point, you want to add carbs in to get really lean, to build the muscle. Right?
Okay.
So it's really exciting. It's great of you to actually do this.
Look forward to it.
It's great of you to do it on camera, because I know that takes some courage, but you're probably going to help a lot of people just by inspiring them.
I'll do my
them.
Best and try to be successful so others can see it.
Thank you.